Hey HubSpotters, today I'm going to tell you about an awesome tool available right inside the HubSpot CRM called the Meetings Tool. It's available on all the versions of the HubSpot CRM, including the free version, so everybody can use it, which is great. The only difference is the free version is only going to allow you to set up one meeting link, while the starter version and the sales professional version will allow you to create multiple links so you can set up a bunch of different meeting types if that's what you want to do. A couple small other changes or differences between the versions, and I'll explain them kind of as we go. So what you're looking at here is what happens when somebody clicks on your meetings link. So what this is designed to do is eliminate all of that back and forth that you have when you're trying to schedule a meeting with a prospect or customer. So a lot of times there's email back and forth asking them if they want to meet, when they're available, and then trying to find a time that works for both of you can, you know, it can take a lot of emails and a lot of time to get that all set up. So with the meetings tool, you get a link, you can send that link out to them, and then when they click on that link, they'll see a screen like this that allows them to book a meeting directly on your calendar. So they click on the link, they come to a screen like this. I have this particular meeting set up so that they can book anytime this week or next week. So you can see the days that are kind of brighter here are options for them to book a meeting. So they click on the day that works best for them. I have this meeting set up to be either a 15, 30, or 60 minute meeting, so they can select their duration just by clicking on any of these circles here. And then once they pick the duration they want, they can find a time that works best for them. So the way that it works is it's integrated directly with my Google Calendar. So any meetings that I have on the 14th will already be blocked off here, so it won't be an option. So you'll see there's less options if they want to do an hour-long meeting than if they wanted to do a 30-minute meeting because I've got some meetings scheduled on that day. So let's say they wanted to do a 30-minute meeting on the 14th at noon. So they can click there. You're going to fill out this form, which we'll also set up when we set up the meetings link. Once they fill it up, they'll hit confirm, and it's going to put the meeting directly onto your calendar. It'll send you an email notification as well, and it's going to email them a calendar invite so they can easily put it on their calendar. You'll also be able to customize the details of that meeting invite. So for example, for this meeting, I have it set up so that it has our conference call-in line details all in there, so they can just call into that conference line at the time of their meeting. So now let's show you how to set that up. So I'm going to do that in our test portal. Our test portal is set up with the free version of the CRM. So those of you that are on the free version, this is exactly what you'll see. And I'll point out some additional things that you get if you're on the sales starter or sales professional. So the first thing that you're going to want to make sure that you do is make sure that you're on your sales screen. So if you have the marketing tools as well, you'll see, you know, you'll be able to select this sales or marketing dropdown. You'll want to make sure that it says sales in this top left-hand corner. Then you're going to go to sales tools and meetings. So the first thing it's going to have you do is connect to your Google Calendar or your Office 365 calendar. I use Google Calendar, so I'm going to hit that option quick. It's going to ask you to accept some terms, and then it'll have you sign in to Google with the account that you want to use. So let me get signed in really quick. All right, so I'm all signed in. It'll have you accept these terms and conditions quick. Hit allow. And then it'll take just a couple seconds to integrate with your calendar. So this is the first thing you'll see if you haven't set it up or played around in this tool. It'll walk you through a quick little tutorial, though it doesn't walk you through everything. So I'm going to go through this tutorial with you, and then I'll show you some of the things that you need to go back in and change. So the first thing that it's going to have you do is set your availability. So it's automatically going to block off any meetings that you already have on the calendar you just integrated with. But you know, you probably don't have any meetings set up on that calendar for 3 a.m., but you also don't want to allow your prospects or your customers to set up a meeting at 3 a.m. So let's say you wanted to do 9 to 5 Monday through Friday. So the easiest way to do that is to hit this little copy button here and check on the days that you want that availability copied to. Hit apply, and that's all across the board. You can also just kind of add blocks in and delete them as you wish. So you don't have to have the same availability on every day if you don't want. Once you have your availability all set up, you go ahead and hit next. And this is where it's going to have you build the form. So this is one of the differences that you have when you're on the free version versus sales starter or sales professional. So if you have starter or professional, you can add other questions here and build out this form however you would like. If you're on just the free version of the HubSpot CRM, you'll just be able to do the first name, last name, and email, although that's usually enough for the people that are using that free version. So you'll set up your form, then hit next. And it's just going to walk you through a little bit of a tutorial on what it looks like for your customer, just so you have an idea, so you can walk through and set up a test meeting if you want. This is what it looks like on desktop, as I showed you earlier. And then this is what it looks like on mobile. So nice, clean mobile experience. You pick your day, and then it kind of walks you through the rest of those steps. So after you're done playing around with that, you can hit next, and it's going to give you the link. So you can use this link, send it out in your email. You can put it on a web page if it makes sense there. So I'm going to walk you through a couple other things you want to go back and edit after this tutorial. Before I do that, I want to point out one other difference that there is between the free CRM and the starter and the professional, and that's being able to embed it on your website. So we use this quite a bit because we're on the sales professional. I'll show you how we use it, a use case for that at the end of the video, but just kind of know that that is another difference that you have there. So hit done after that's all set up. Okay, so now you're going to want to go back in and customize some settings. So you're going to go back in here and hit edit. So this is that meeting that you just set up, and this is the link you can send out. I'm going to hit edit because I want to make a couple more changes. So this page allows you to change the name of the meeting or the headline that's going to show up on that meetings page. So you can see, you know, here I have find a time for a call with Tyler, just a little bit more personal than this here. And that meeting link I only use for people that are remote or people that I just want to have phone conversations with. So find a time to meet with me doesn't make as much sense. You can also change this meeting name. So this is going to be that internal meeting. And so it's also going to be the text that when you insert it into an email using, you can actually use this a drop down inside the contact record in the CRM if you're emailing from inside there. You can also do that if you've got the Google Gmail integration. So whenever you do that, this is the text that will appear there. So you might say something like, click here to book a time in my online calendar. That might make more sense. Although remember that this is also that internal name. So if all of your meetings are called that, it might be kind of hard for you to determine which meeting is which in that dropdown. It just kind of depends on what makes sense for you. You can always change that text in the email as well. So it's not too important that this is nailed down right now. Down here, you set your duration. So if you want to allow 15, 30 minutes or an hour, or let's say you're just going to use this to set up an hour-long meeting, you could delete those durations. If you wanted to add another, like let's say I want to add that 30-minute duration back in there, I can do that. So click Add a Duration and then just type in whatever that duration is. So that's the settings on this page. This next screen is pretty important, and they hide a lot of that important stuff under that advanced setting, so don't skip over this. But first, we're going to talk about this stuff. So location, this is going to be the details that show up in the calendar invite that goes out to your prospect's email after they book this time. So like I mentioned, I have our conference line details in there. I put that here. For meetings that are going to occur at our office, I've got a meeting type set up for that, and I have the address of our office here. The subject will be what is the name of the meeting on their calendar, and also the subject of the email for the calendar invite that goes out, and then you can add any other details here. So now these advanced settings, these are pretty important for your own time management. So this minimum notice time and this buffer time are what I'm talking about here. So minimum notice time. Right now, the way that it's set up is I can schedule a meeting, or somebody could schedule a meeting with me that's going to happen 15 minutes from now. That, for me, that's not enough notice time. So I have this set up for a few hours for most of mine. You could even do a day if you wanted to. So just keep this in mind. You're probably going to want this to be longer than 15 minutes. Buffer time is going to be the amount of time that it adds to as before and after each meeting that's on your calendar. So let's say I've got a meeting at 1, it's going to get over at 2. Right now, the first time somebody could book me would be 2:15. So if you've got to do call prep or you're doing in-person meetings, you've got to travel between locations, you may want that buffer time to be a little bit higher. This is how far out into the future they can schedule it. So like the one I showed you was this week and next week. You can add more time to that if you want. And then you can do language, date, and number format if you're working in a different language. Our platform is set up for English, so we don't have to change any of those settings. So make sure that you click into these advanced settings and get those set up the way you want. Everything else in here is going to be what we saw in that first tutorial. So availability, the form, and that's going to be it. So if you have the sales starter or sales professional, you can create more links. All you have to do is come up here and you can create a personal is just like the one we created. You can also create meeting links for your team. So if there's gonna be more than one of you in the meeting, it'll look at all of the calendars for the people involved and find the times that are available, put the meeting invite, the calendar invite on all of those calendars that are linked up. So that's pretty helpful for team situations as well. So I've got my one set up, so you can use this link. I could send this link out in any email right now and people could book meetings with me. So I wanna show you just real quick how we use meetings for our company. Since we have that sales professional version, we can have multiple meeting links. So jump back over here. So you can see I've got, you know, quite a few different versions. I won't go through all of these, but you know, everything from just a call with me that I use for our customers to a connect call that I use for prospects that I'm just trying to qualify. You can see I've got this limited to 20 minutes. I've got my meet with me. So that is the version that is set up for an in-person meeting. So a little bit more buffer time. It's got our office address in there. This 30-minute marketing consultation is what I want to dive into a little bit deeper, because this is the one that we use that option where it allows us to actually embed that tool into our website. So I'm going to show you how we use that really quick. I'm going to go to our website. So if you've ever been to our website, you've probably noticed that we have free consultation call to actions pretty much everywhere. So I'm going to click on that. Got this set up with a landing page. So this is just a HubSpot landing page. We got a form here that asks a bunch of questions to help us prepare for the consultation that we're having with that prospect. So this is pre-populated with my information since we use HubSpot. So I'm gonna go ahead and schedule my call. And then it takes us to a thank you page that's also in HubSpot that has that embedded in it. So this allows us to, you know, customize this with the look and feel of our website, has some instructions for a prospect. So basically gives us a little bit more room to work with and flexibility than just the default page that looks like this. So that's how we use that embed tool. If you're using Starter or Sales Professional, that's going to be an option for you. So that's all there is to it. I hope that meetings tool gives you a ton of value and gives you some of your time back. I know as salespeople, that time is super important. So hopefully this was helpful for you. Happy HubSpotting.